Now class, we are beginning with our second video of revision of force, and we are now defining the term force. We have discussed earlier ki what is force. Force is a push or pull. Push means we can get a body away from us. Pull means we can bring a body towards us, and it can be any kind of force. It can be mechanical force. Mechanical force means with the help of muscles we can apply, and electrical force means it can be made with the help of electrical devices. And so this is what force is. Force is a push or pull, and it can have various sources. It can be mechanical, non-mechanical, natural, anything. Okay, now what can force do? Force can we can change the shape and size of the body by crumbling force on a piece of paper. We can change the shape of the paper piece. Okay, so we can change the shape and size of the body easily with the help of force. Now the another changes that can be brought up by forces are, it can bring a body at rest into motion. Obviously, when we are kicking the football, when we are kicking something, so we are bringing a body at rest into motion. And suppose a car is coming from an opposite direction, or cycle is coming, so with our hands we can stop the body. So with force we can bring us body at rest into motion. We can bring a body into motion at rest, and we can also change the direction. Obviously, we have discussed this in inertia of direction by changing the direction of the steering, or by changing the direction of our hands, we can change the direction of a moving body. So these are the consequences of applying force. Now one factor, the most important factor on which force depends upon mass of the body. This is very evident and inevitable. If the mass of the body is less, so you need to apply less force, and if the mass of the body is greater, you need to apply greater force. Okay, so suppose I am to push a small car, then I will suppose I am applying some force. But if I am to push a truck, then I need a much more larger force. So that means force directly depends upon the mass of the body on which you are applying it. And again, it can be push or pull. Either you can pull a body or you can push a body. So this is what force is. Now class, we are again discussing another topic, balanced and unbalanced forces. What are balanced forces? Firstly, we are understanding this with the help of example of tug of war, in which there are two opponents or two teams on the opposite side of the rope, and we are pulling the opponents of the on the other side of the rope. So suppose if no one is winning, suppose this is person A, person B, and they are playing tug of war. And if both are applying equal force, 100 newton, and newton is what? SI unit of force, okay? Named after scientist Sir Isaac Newton. So both persons are applying same force. This person is pulling, and the other person in with force of 100 newton, and this person is being pulled in opposite direction with force of what? 100 newton. So both forces cancels out. Why canceling out? Because force is a vector quantity. It comes with direction. Suppose we are considering this direction as positive. So we are taking this positive. So this will be negative. So plus 100 minus 100 will give what? Zero. So what are balanced forces? Balanced forces are those forces in which the sum of all the forces acting on a body is zero. Okay. Now what is unbalanced force? Suppose this person won the competition of tug of war, which means he applied greater force. He pulled this person with force of 200 newton, while this person was trying to pull this person with force of what? 100 newton. Again, we are using sign convention. With this direction, we are considering plus. So this is plus, this is minus. So what is the net force? If I am to write minus 200 plus 100, which will give minus 100. So this means this person won, and he pulled this person with force of 100 newton, extra 100 newton, and minus sign is indicating that this person got pulled in this direction. So this is unbalanced force. So when the sum of vector sum means we are taking the sign. When the vector sum of all the forces is zero, that is called balanced force or balanced forces. And when vector sum of forces is not zero, that is called unbalanced forces. And when the forces are balanced, when the forces are balanced, most important point, acceleration of the body will be zero, which I'll explain you in the next example. Okay.